Hello friends, welcome to the session on Python programming. In this session, we'll be discussing about data types in Python programming language. In this session, we will see what are the different data types that are available in the Python programming language and how we can make the use of these data types. What kind of values can be assigned to the variables by using these data types. So whenever we consider any programming language, then every programming language will provide a facility through which we can assign the different data values to the variables. And this facility is being called as a data type in the programming language. So friends, as you know that you are viewing this session on my YouTube channel, and you can subscribe to the channel so that you can watch many other videos on the various topics of the subjects of electronics and computer science. So let us start the session with the question, what are the different data types that are being available in the Python programming language? In real life, one can easily find that there are different data values, and we need to deal with these different data values. So in programming languages also, there must be some provision to deal with the different data values. And this provision in the programming language is being called as a data type. So every value belongs to the specific data type in the Python programming language. So data type, you can say, will identify the type of the data value a variable can hold. So whenever we make the use of variables within the program, then we need to assign certain value to these variables. So what kind of values can be assigned to the variables will be decided by the data type of that variable. Also, what kind of operations that we can perform on these data values will also be decided by the type of the data. So from this chart, one can easily find that there are large number of data types available in Python. As far as the numbers or numeric values are concerned, we have integer number, float number, and also the complex number. So Python is a programming language which will provide you the data type of the complex number, which otherwise is not available in many other programming languages. It has a data type called as a Boolean. It has a data type called as a set, which also is not available in many other programming languages. Also, it is possible that we can have a sequence type, and in the sequence type, we have strings, list, and tuple. So Python, you can say, is a rich programming language as far as the data types are concerned. Also, in Python programming language, we have a data type called as mapping. And in the mapping, we have so far only one data type called as a dictionary. So these are very useful data type. And you will find that whenever we need to deal with different sets of values, then we can make the use of these data types. In Python, one has to remember that the list and dictionary are the mutable data types, that is, their values can be changed. But the other data types are immutable. Means, say, for example, integer, float, complex number, all other data types are the immutable. That is, their values cannot be changed. It means that whenever we assign some variable x, say some integer value, then it is fixed for that variable. Now, if you reassign a new value to the variable x, then that will be treated as a new variable, and its memory location will be different from that of the earlier variable. So while dealing with the data types, one has to remember that only list and dictionary are the mutable data types, that is, their values can be changed. Otherwise, all other data types are immutable. So let us understand what are the different numbers in the Python. So number data type or numerical data type is used to store only numbers. And we have three types of numbers: integer, float, and complex. So for example, we can have the integer number where there is a positive integer value or negative integer value. As far as the real number or float number are concerned, so you will find that it is a fractional number. So it will have integer part and fractional part. And in the complex number, there is again a two-part number. The first part is the integer and the second part is the complex part with the variable j. So when we write the number such as 3 plus 4j, it becomes a complex number. As far as the Boolean data type is concerned, you can say that Boolean data type is a kind of subtype of the integer. So it is a unique data type and it will consist of only two constants, that is true and false. So in Python, whenever we say the Boolean value true, it means that it is a non-zero value or non-null value and non-empty value. And whenever we say Boolean false, then it means that it is a zero value. So for example, if I write a variable number 1 is equal to 100, and if I make the use of the function type, then it will return me the type of the number 1, and that is integer. If I assign a value number 2 is equal to 123.456, and if I make the use of the function type number 2, then it will return me the class float. If I write a number 3 is equal to 4 plus 4j on the Python prompt, and then if I ask for the type of number 3, then it will return us the complex type. And whenever we type number 4 is equal to true, and if we ask to return the type of the number 4, then it will return us the type Boolean. So you can type such small commands on the Python interpreter, and immediately you can check with what are the different semantics that is being associated with the different data types. A Python sequence is a very useful data type, and one can say that it is an ordered collection of items where each item is being indexed by an integer. So there are three types of sequences that are being permitted in Python: strings, list, and tuples. So string, you can say, is a group of characters. So these characters may be alphabets, or these characters may be digits, or even it's possible that you can make the use of special characters, including spaces, in the strings. So whenever we want to declare the string values in the Python programming, then we need to include the strings either in single quotation mark, or you can include it in the double quotation mark. So both ways is permitted. Either you can include the string in the single quotation, or it can be included in the double quotation. And the quotes are not the part of the string, so just they are indicating the beginning of the string and the end of the string. So for the interpreter, the quotation mark is just an indication of the string. So as far as the strings are concerned, we cannot perform any numerical operations on the strings. So even if we declare some string as a number, so for example, when I write string 2 is equal to in the quotation mark 532, then it becomes a string and it is not a number. And therefore, as far as the strings are concerned, it is not possible that we can perform any numerical operation on the strings. There is another useful data type called as a list. List sometimes is also called as an array in many other programming languages, where you can say that list is a sequence of items. And the items are being separated by the comma, and the items are needed to be enclosed in the square bracket. So in Python, wherever you want to declare a list, then it is necessary that you can make the use of square brackets, and you have to write down all the elements of the list in the square bracket. So for example, if I like write a list one in the square bracket 5, 3.4, comma a string Aurangabad, comma a 20C, comma 22, and if I give a command print list one, then you will find that the content of the list will be printed. So one can easily observe that it is not necessary that the list should contain only one type of data elements. So it is possible that the list may contain the different types of data elements. Tuple is another sequence of atoms that is being separated by the commas, and the atoms need to be enclosed in the parentheses. So tuple is unlike the list, where the values are enclosed in the bracket. While in the tuple, the list are, the values are enclosed in the parentheses. And the advantage with the tuple is that once it has been created, then we cannot change the content of the tuple. So for example, if I write a tuple one consisting of elements 24, 32, India, comma A, and if I give a command print tuple one, then the values of the tuple one will be printed on the screen. So list and tuple both are a sequence of atoms, but in the list it is possible that you can change the elements, but in tuple you cannot make the change in the elements. Also in list, the elements are enclosed in the square bracket, while in case of tuple, the elements are enclosed in the simple parentheses. So while selecting the data type, it is necessary for a programmer to select the data type appropriately. So if you want to make the changes in the values, then you can go for the list. If you do not want to make the changes in the values, then you can go for a tuple. Set is another unordered collection of the atoms, where the elements are being separated by the comma and the atoms are enclosed in the curly brackets. So set, you can say, is similar to the list. So in discrete mathematics, we always practice the set. So the same set is being provided as a data type in the Python. So the difference is that it cannot have the duplicate entries. So even if you write the duplicate entries in the set, they will be considered only once. So one element can occur only once in a set. And once created, the elements of the set cannot be changed. So for example, if I create a set one, which consists of the number of elements in the curly brackets, such as 24, 56.5, Parbhani, comma 1, comma 1. So here one can observe that here one is being repeated. But if I give a command to print the content of the set one, then one easily observe that the one will appear only once. So even if you write number of elements same, then it is being treated once only. None is also a special data type with a single value. It is used to signify the absence of a value in a situation. So if you do not want to specify any value to the variable, then in that case, you can make the use of none. None supports no special operations. And also one has to remember that none is neither a false nor a zero. So for example, if I have a variable one, which is equal to none, and if I print the value of this variable one, then one can easily observe that none will be displayed on the screen. Mapping is another data type, and it is also an ordered data type in the Python. So as far as the current version of the Python interpreter is concerned, there is only one standard mapping data type, and it is being called as a dictionary. So dictionary is just like a telephone dictionary, where we know that in telephone dictionary, we have a name associated with some number. So every name has a different number. So similarly, dictionary in the Python will hold the data items in the key value pairs. So there is a pair of values. Atoms in the dictionary need to be enclosed in the curly brackets. Dictionary is a very useful data type because it will permit us faster access to the data. Every key is being separated from its value using a colon sign. So we write the key colon value pairs of a dictionary can be accessed by using the key. So whenever we want to make an access, then that access can be made by using the key. The keys are usually the strings, and their values can be any data type. Any valid data type can be used as the values. So in order to access any value in the dictionary, we have to specify its key in the square bracket. So for example, if I want to create a dictionary, such as dictionary one, college, so this is a string, DSMP, colon, DSMP, course, colon, BSCCS, marks, colon, 500. So one can easily observe that as far as the first two values are concerned, we are making the use of the strings. But as far as this third value is concerned, we are making the use of integer value. So if I give the command print dictionary one, then the content of the dictionary will be displayed on the screen. So dictionary is also a very useful data type. And in many programming situations, programmer will find of using the dictionary for storing the data values. So thank you, friends, for viewing the session. Hopefully you have understood what are the different data types that are available in the Python and how we can assign values to the variables of these different data types. Thank you all for viewing the session.